So we're going to have a look at the preferences settings on Firefox. On the content tab, we have a number of options here, such as changing the default font that's used, perhaps to something that the user finds far easier to read on screen, and of course an ability to change the default font size. We've also got an advanced tab, and that will allow us to change the proportional or serif or sans serif base, so a bit more control there. And again, the ability to set sizes for different fonts, including the minimum font size, so that's always a really good option to know about. We also have a checkbox to say, you know, allow websites to override my settings or make sure that my settings always apply, and that can be useful on a Moodle course, for example. We also have colors set in the same way, so perhaps someone who's colorblind to blue could change the visited links to red, and that's going to work a lot better for them, obviously. The option to remove the underline from links may help with readability. And we can apply the system colors, so if the actual operating system has been set up with colors, that's good. And again, an option to allow pages to choose their own colors or not, to always apply the user colors. There's also a help button there, and that will take us to the fonts and colors documentation on the supportmozilla.com site, which is useful, interesting reading. I'm just gonna not save any of my settings and cancel those boxes for now. In Safari, we have similar settings. There's a pop-up blocker on the file menu, but also within preferences, we have a number of tabs. First of all, the appearance tab, which allows us to change both the standard font or the fixed width font to choose a particular size or style for that, which is obviously really useful. People that struggle perhaps with the font size and change the typeface as well. And over on the advanced tab, we also have options to set the minimum or universal access, as it's called here, minimum font size. Really useful if you've forgotten your glasses or struggle with text on screen. And style sheets, which is quite an advanced option. And if we click on the help button, that will actually take us to a description of that. But basically, style sheets allow all the styles to be overridden in a very granular way. It's quite an advanced topic, but there are style sheets available to download.